we are extremely excited because since pandemic, people have actually have changed. Everybody has become part of the customer service. So before I get started into it, my name is Amir Kaleem. I'm Team's team, and my partner in crime here is
Sean Gilmore. Sorry, I didn't know it was really hot there. Yeah.
So this, you probably have seen, the coolest figure on this chart is 20 million plus monthly active users.
For phone.
And that is amazing. And thank you so much for your trust into our cloud calling. And I couldn't be excited more. I started this journey about 16 years with Microsoft. I had no background at the time of Microsoft. I was probably dangerous to even spell 80, but I'm so proud that we were able to deliver this kind of impact to our customers. So thank you so much for your trusting our cloud control. So let's get into it. I'm gonna let Sean go over and show you some cool demos about the queue apps, but you know, call queues were already there. So we wanted to provide you a much more simpler, delightful way to leverage that and make the life of people who are in the departmental scenario acting as an agents and supporting internal or external scenarios. We wanted to make sure that they had the right tools in Teams right there as a collaborative queue apps. So I'm gonna leave that, but I'm gonna quickly touch on the next two strategy pillars. So we are completely committed to this space, and our play has been since forever, and which is we have done here in Teams as well, is the certified partner-led contact center solution. We have over 19 of them, and you name it, from Five Nines to Cisco to Avaya, Anywhere 365, Nice, you know, Luware. So there is a whole bunch of them and more. People are in the pipeline, people are joining us, and they wanna basically have their users, subject matter experts, and their agents in the same collaboration realm. So Teams is de facto have become with the 320 million users from that standpoint. So the key piece there is that the customer wants to adopt Teams phone system or Teams call control, but they wanna protect their investments. And contact center is a very custom deployment. So that's where it is important to connect with them. Same way, if you are looking for a Microsoft solution, so Dynamics 365 people with omni-channel customer service, absolutely. You get that embedded chat, you get that conversational AI, co-pilot enabled, right state of the art, right from Microsoft. Basically, that solution is right there from that standpoint. Let me quickly go over some scenarios. This is interesting from that standpoint that internal facing IT help desk, service desks, something even people, if you have been in a SOX, security is a big time top of mind for people. So it is a departmental scenario where you don't have to put a complete, a license for a user to service your user. And it's becomes very important from cost standpoint that you have the right capabilities and right matrix, that you still provide the queuing, you still provide those capabilities that people can join the queue and not join the queue and provide the service, but they can provide that help desk service. Now, let me quickly tell you one more interesting thing is that this learning coming from pandemic was this, that the foot traffic, we all experienced the foot traffic went away. In as simple as in a retail shop, in a wine shop, foot traffic went away. People would walk in into a wine shop and they would ask that, hey, what kind, I'm throwing this party, what kind of wine? And I'm picking an example of retail, what kind of wine I should serve this and have a conversation. Well, they started to call. When they started to call, there was probably one POTS line coming in a manager's room or somewhere, and it was getting DSAT. So people had to quickly, in retail, in healthcare, in airline operations, and DMVs and city services, has to come up with a solution, and they turned towards us on Teams, Teams call queues and Teams. That was really amazing. So I'll encourage you to search some very famous people got married and got their marriage license on Teams during pandemic. That was really fun to build that application. Same way, which is very near and dear to my heart, in state of Illinois, we built a childcare application where kids in distress, they could reach out to their case officer using Teams securely without needing to go with somebody else sort of thing. So that was so they could share the experience they were going through that. really cool scenario from that standpoint. I really enjoy that. Lot of digital justice, the court systems, you know, they all went virtual. So how do you basically surface that? Those are departmental scenarios where you didn't need a full blown, like you are not American Airlines or United Airlines or Bank of America, where you need that contact center with call, you know, workflows of more than 15,000 people in a single queue or something like that sort of thing. So that's where it becomes very, very interesting from that standpoint. Last piece is that as the people basically went away from normal PBX and the switchboards, they expect the same experience. So for example, if I call, let's say a bank, and I call the LDN of the bank, listed directory number of the bank, I would basically would expect that if I'm calling investment bank, then they would say that, you know, welcome to the investment bank. If I'm calling the same financial institution, but I'm calling the asset management, then somebody should say same. Actually, there's the same group of people, but they know that what the call is coming in from. So we basically, from the call queues, provide that capability from right from the switchboard and auto attenders from that standpoint. Let me hand it over to Sean to show you some cool things.
So as Amar talked about, one of the important things that we've started to recognize, call queues are a pretty big business for us on the team side. And we've had voice-enabled channels for a really long time, but there's limitations around voice-enabled channels, and there's specific needs that are maybe not as best served in that space. And as Amar alluded to, we see a larger drive towards what we call citizen agents. These aren't contact center agents. They're not people that are on the phone 8 hours a day answering customer calls, and that's all they do. There's beautiful solutions for things like that from our friends over at Landis. They build great ones. And we're not looking to or seeking to replace those. But we know that there's a lot of scenarios where people are working in teams day to day, you know, information workers, whether it's people in HR or people in an internal help desk who use Teams to collaborate to solve problems. And they want to funnel the calls into Teams. And today, there's really not a lot of choice. You got VEC, which has some limitations, and you have just ring the phone. And that's all you got. So what we're introducing is what we call the Queues app. And you may have heard this under a couple of different names at some point. I think at some point we may have called it the Agents app. We don't necessarily talk about these folks as agents necessarily because that isn't their job. And so with the Agents app, what we're doing is creating a home for these groups of folks to work together, to have an understanding of what's going on in the queue, have a view on real-time analytics for the queue, a view on historic analytics for the queue, as well as the ability to see, you know, their shared call history. That's an eventual thing. And the ability to interact with one another or simply opt themselves in, which today, if anyone has to deal with this, is actually a pretty convoluted step. So it's a very simple thing to sort of think about. We're also building a lot of details and capabilities around what are called authorized users in TAC. We tend to shorthand that for supervisors. But the folks that are actually in charge of managing groups of contact center folk or contact agents dealing with the call queues. And so we're trying to put together a whole set of capabilities for those folks, both in the sort of analytics side, the ability to see details on all of the call queues and the auto attendants that they run and own, as well as to manage them. So you can see we're moving into sort of robust supervisor management of call queues. So you can opt yourself in as a supervisor and start answering calls. You can manage the call queue lineup. So you need to add people, you need to enable people, you can do it as a supervisor today. You need to change the greetings, change the office hours. We know also talking with partners, there's a lot of SMBs that deploy call queues for their services. A lot of partners get stuck managing these kinds of things for those SMBs. And now you can actually put the controls of that into the hands of the folks that manage that space, and they can change their office hours for holidays or change their greetings for holidays. So that's what we're sort of doing. And you can see the agent view is just a little bit simpler. We want them to be able to focus. There is still data there. These are sort of shots of the initial wave of things that we'll put through. As I was talking with someone earlier, we're going to listen to feedback as we go and continue to add additional analytics and additional data and surface that here. And then a little bit of a preview of what's coming. We're also adding the ability to monitor, whisper, barge, and take over calls for supervisors. So they'll actually be able to listen in on an agent's call, whisper to that agent if they need to barge in, if it's important enough for them to do, and actually take over. So, you know, just take kick the agent out, take it over for them. So that's all what's coming. Here's a little bit of a view of rich call history. Over time, this will evolve into a shared call history space where you'll be able to see all the calls for queue. The agents will be able to see the other calls that have gone on. You'll be able to do some more robust things about missed call management, shared voicemail, things like that. So we have a bit more time. I went a little fast. But at the same time, if there are questions, I'm happy to answer questions. Yeah.
Last part, do you only see the call history in the Queues app, or can you see that as a regular agent just logged in on the channel?
So it will depend on how it's set up, but this this will be in the Queues app only. So when we go to shared call history, it'll be a Queues app feature.
So anybody that has that will need the Queues app to see the history that it crossed it. Okay, yeah. Thanks.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. The ask was, will agents be able to see the shared call history in the Queues app? And the answer is yes. If it's set up that way, you could just have it have supervisors do that. So, yes, it's going to be under Teams Premium. And you can, in fact, and maybe I shouldn't say this, are there any of the Teams Premium people here? No? Okay. We understand that there are capabilities that maybe you just want, say, for supervisors. In that case, you just put the supervisors under a Teams Premium license if you don't feel like the agents get value from it. We're hoping that we build enough value for the folks in the call queue, the members of the call queue, that they actually want to use it and you want them to use it. But we understand if you just want the supervisors being able to manage the call queues.
Are you going to change how voicemail is handled? Now we have to go in 365 group.
Are we going to change the way voicemail is handled? That's definitely something we're looking at. As we think about something like a shared call history, it doesn't make a lot of sense for us to not go and sort of dig into that space and make it better. And even talk about lightweight workflows. I mean, we're not going to build anything super complex. We're not interested in building ticketing systems or anything like that. That's not our purview. In fact, we'd love to be able to partner with companies that do that as we evolve calling and allow for third-party apps to come in and play more. So it's definitely something we're looking at.
Since you're kind of moving away from the voice-enabled channel and a team and stuff.
Yeah.
Right now, you kind of use the shared voicemail box of the team.
Right. Yeah.
Was there a plan to do something else for storage?
Yeah, we're going to do something else that'll make it and allow it to be more accessible and more manageable.
I think that'll alleviate all of our users' complaints.
I'm glad to hear about that. Yeah, go ahead. GA is later this summer. Yeah, it is in private preview right now, and it'll likely expand a little bit later, maybe hopefully later this month we'll allow some Teams Premium customers to start leveraging, but right now it's in private preview with about 150 customers.
I was just wondering how soon will the rich call history feature...
Sorry, I can't
hear. The rich call history feature, we're in private preview
That's
right
later.
Now, but even for private preview, it's later.
It's not.
Okay.
I'm sharing things I probably shouldn't do. Don't tell anyone. We've talked about it a little bit, but not broadly.
Integration with Dynamics 365, how does this work alongside of like Teams in Dynamics 365?
Sure, yeah. So initially, we're limited. So as maybe some of you are aware, we support what we call Screen Pop today, which is the ability to launch an app based on an incoming call to a PSTN number. Which is a poor man's version of extensibility, quite frankly. We are working really hard to be able to support a broad set of third parties, both within the call frame itself. So if you're on a call, you can get Dynamics CRM or honestly any third party, right? Microsoft builds platforms. So we want everyone to come and join us. And then longer term, we'll probably see that in the Queues app itself. You can imagine that there's lots of very powerful third party apps for doing deeper analytic dives, you know, reasoning over multiple calls and things like that. And we want to offer them the ability to integrate with the Queues app, which makes sense. So, yeah, absolutely.
Amazing. Thank you.
It was a lightning talk, wasn't it?
It was a lightning talk. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.